Hey folks, in this episode of Dev with Serdar, we're going to cover another of the new features introduced in Python 3.12, now out in beta. So download it and try it out, but don't yet use it for anything in production until it's fully released later this year. So one of the new things that's come to Python 3.12 is a way to make classes in Python that expose the Python buffer protocol. The buffer protocol is a relatively low-level feature in Python. It's a way to get or give access to the underlying region of raw memory that is wrapped by certain Python objects, like bytes or byte array objects. Now, typically, if you wanted to get or give access to the buffer protocol, you had to do this through a C extension. You couldn't write a plain old Python class that exposed the buffer protocol, and Python code has had no way historically of knowing if a given object supports it. But with 3.12, there is a new dunder method that you can create for Python objects called buffer. You can create a memory region with something like the bytes or byte array built-ins, and then from your buffer dunder, you can return a memory view object for accessing that memory. How the buffer is created is entirely up to you. You could invoke a C library to do it. You could use a Python built-in. What matters is that you return a memory view object that points to the buffer and that the buffer persists for the lifetime of the memory view. Now, to demonstrate all this, I have a simple example. This has been modified somewhat from Python's own example in its documentation. It's called the buffstring class, and what it does is it takes in a string, converts it into a mutable byte array object, and then when you request a buffer from this object using the buffer dunder, it returns a memory view to that byte array. Now, if you're not familiar with what a memory view is, it's not a new thing. It's something that's been in Python for quite some time. It is more or less exactly what it sounds like. It's a view into the memory of an object that supports the buffer protocol. In this case, the byte array object that we created. We're going to use the byte array's memory view as the memory view for what we return to the user through this class. And what makes memory views useful is they let us do stuff with the underlying memory without making copies of it. So for instance, if you make a slice, the slice is just going to point to the underlying data in the memory view. And depending on the type of object, whether or not it's read-only, for instance, you can also write to indexes or ranges in the memory view. What you cannot do is resize it, because then you'd have to create a new buffer, copy into it, and abandon the old one, which would have bad consequences for the memory view object. But you can access, you can slice without copying, and if the object allows it, you can modify contents in place. By the way, at the current time, the type annotation system in Python does not allow you to hint whether or not a buffer protocol object is read-only. That is something that might come later, though. For now, we're assuming that the buffer protocols we're creating for this example are readable and writable. Now, along with the buffer dunder, there's another dunder called release buffer. And this is for disposing of the memory that we have allocated, or at the very least, disposing of the memory view that we've created. And in this case, we're just disposing of the memory view object for this particular class by setting it to none. We are, in this case, still keeping the underlying array of memory that was exposed by the memory view. It's our byte array object here. But there may be cases where we would want to dispose of that underlying data also, and this would give us an opportunity to do it. Now, let me walk through how all of this works from the top. So first, we create a new instance of buffstring. It creates the underlying data in this byte array, and it holds a reference to it in the object. Now, if we create a memory view object from buffstring, what we get back is the memory view that we created in the buffer dunder. This is a view to the byte array data. And by the way, if we use with to create the memory view like this, this gives us control over the lifetime of the memory view. What happens is that as soon as we go out of scope from this with block, the release buffer dunder gets called. And while that with block is in effect, and this is the really important part, we don't want to do anything with the underlying data, because then we could have unpredictable behavior. Let me show you an example of why this matters. With this object, we have the add dunder defined, so we could take our existing string data, combine it with something else, and in doing so, manipulate the underlying byte array. But we cannot have a memory view open to that data when we modify it. So we have to, in this section here, raise a runtime error to prevent that from happening. So if we uncommented out this code, if we tried to make this modification I'm talking about while this memory view is still enabled, we'd get a crash. However, once we leave this with block and we close the memory view, we can then access the underlying data and make changes to it. And so if after we do that, we open another memory view to the object, we can see that things have in fact changed. So to sum up, the new buffer dunder in Python lets you create classes that can expose the buffer protocol without having to write a C extension. All that matters is that you return a memory view to the data in question that you want to provide through the buffer protocol, and you have to make sure not to let the underlying data be modified while you have a memory view open to it. So that's it for now. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.